Hey guys, it's Fusion Timmy here. It's been what, a few weeks, almost a month? It's been a while since my last video. And you're probably wondering, okay, so Timmy, what took so long? Where have you been? I've been needing more videos, man. Okay, so like, here's the gist of it. I got sick, okay? I got really sick and it kind of threw me off. And then I kind of needed a break because I've been doing nonstop YouTube for like months now. As you can probably assume, these videos take me hours to create, sometimes days to create, so there's a lot of work. I really just wanted to focus on some other things, and I was sick for over a week, so that was a really big part of it, and it's just been like off and on different things going on. However, I'm finally back, and while my next video won't be Dragon Ball related, I figured I'd come back and do a Dragon Ball video at least to start off with, because that's what you guys tend to love the most. However, be expecting a lot more other types of content coming up next. Dragon Ball is not all I do, it's just something I've tend to do more recently because you guys love it so much. And since the hype is there, might as well provide. You gotta do what the fans want. Today we'll be playing as Vegeta, the Prince of All Saiyans. We've done this once before, but it's gonna be much different this time because ever since then, I found new mods and I found new ways to make this a crazy experience. We're not doing Ultra Ego Vegeta, we're doing God of Destruction Vegeta. I'm not saying Ultra Ego won't be there, it definitely will, but we're gonna be surpassing the realm of Ultra Ego Vegeta. We're gonna become the strongest form of Vegeta possible. And if you haven't already, you should go check out my other videos such as Omni King Goku and God Killer Broly. Those are really good videos that I highly recommend you watch. And this is gonna be similar to those two, where it's a really, really overpowered character. And I'm gonna show you guys exactly how I do it. If you guys are ready to spend 100 days with me in Dragon Block Z, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and let's get, wait, is that a Dragon Ball back there? Whoa, okay, we're starting off strong. Anyways, let's get into the video. Yeah, there it is. Yippee! One of the dragon blocks down. So, I guess that happened. We're on like a bunch of islands, which I guess is kind of cool. It's nearby Kame's house and the lookout. I do just have to go straight to the lookout, so you know what? Actually, no, I don't. Because if I go to the lookout, it's not gonna be able to do anything. I don't have any TP. What I need to do is I need to kill some of these cows. Go and charge up our key. We need to charge up our power. Just be able to kill a cow, man. This cow's too strong. Kidding. He's horrible. Either way, we're gonna kill both of these and we're gonna go ahead and grab their meat because we need to be able to eat. And it's during nighttime. And if you guys actually saw Saiyan Saga Vegeta, you would know that he actually used something called a Great Ape form. And for most characters in Dragon Block Z, I would not use that very much. But since we're playing as Vegeta himself, I think it's time we actually use the Great Ape form. Also, I used a custom hair. If you wanted to find the hair that I used for Vegeta in this video, simply go to the hair salon and look for Vegeta hairstyle. This is what it looks like. It's pretty easy to find. And it's already the end of day one, practically? Oh man, all that talking in the intro must have took forever. I have got to get better at doing those intros. I take way too long. Okay, oh yeah, there is a way for me to get a lot of TP fast. So let me go ahead and like just use like 10% of my power. And we're going to go ahead and just use a shadow... Are you serious right now? Okay, well, fine. I'll go find a cow or something. I didn't want to have to do animal abuse, but apparently that's what I've been led to. I found you, Kakarot. Oh, now mobs are spawning. That'll help me get a lot of TP. If they continue to spawn, easy. I'm still one-shotting them with 25% of my power, so let me get to like 10%. I feel like that's pretty reasonable. It sucks that we're stuck on this small little island, but it's a nice change of pace considering normally I have all the land in the world. We're starting at a very humble spot. Oh, here we go. Here's some zombies. Is it just me or are they stronger now? I saw that man have 94 HP on my screen. I don't understand what that meant, but okay. Alright, turbo mode. Go a little faster. Using my key. Still not enough TP? Let's go to Great Ape. Or do you mind? I'm trying to do something right now. I call upon the power of my ancestors. The Great Ape. Die. Okay. Still not enough TP, but you know what we can do? Just do this. It's still not enough TP? Man, we're not getting any TP right now. You know what? Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go out to the island over there, and it seems a lot bigger than the other islands. And since I'm a giant monkey, it shouldn't take too long. Oh yeah, we're soaring. Just imagine seeing a giant monkey in battle armor with a power force around him just going through the water at like Mach 5. Yeah. That would be pretty wild. Well, since we already have a TP over there, all we gotta do is just get over here to this other island. We'll be good to go. I'm gonna turn off my power. I wanna use all of my power. You can see my key's already getting kinda low. I'll probably set a spawn here, like a TP, just so I can be here instead of that other island. This is a little bit bigger. It's a little bit more room for stuff to spawn, a little bit more room for things to happen. That's really what I'm looking for. Alright, so, hello Mr. Spider, you are dead. This is gonna take a while, I just need to go kill a bunch of stuff and hopefully I can get enough TP sooner or later. Okay guys, it's been a couple days, I did actually die, but I made it back and I managed to get my TP up a little bit. I put all of it into mine, I just kept getting TP and kept spamming it into mine as fast as I could. Actually, turns out I had to go mess with my settings because for some reason my JRMC file that I used for like every other video had been reset. So essentially I was having less TP gain. So I only gained like I think 3 TP for all that work I did. And I was wondering why it was so slow. It's because that's the default, right? I always set mine way higher because this game is so slow. I always set it to like 10 times more than it normally is. And that sounds like it'd be a lot, but it's still super slow. It takes me 100 days to get to the very end. So either way, I set it higher and I was easily able to get enough mine to where I'm now officially getting a lot more. I only have 960 TP, but I figured I'd go ahead and put that into the stats with you guys right here. So if you don't know what the stats are, we got strength, which makes me do more damage, dexterity, which is like my defense, and speed, which we will go ahead and do, makes me take less damage. Constitution is my health, which is on the right, so we have 220. We're gonna go ahead and boost that up, and we are out of TP already. But there's constitution, there's willpower, which is like your maximum ki power, which is like how much damage you can do with ki moves. You have mind, which increases your TP gain, which is what I was just talking about, and spirit, which increases my ki pool at the top left. So right now we're at like 50% power, and we got 3,500 battle power. I'm using the false battle power because I prefer it, but you can also use the more realistic one if you wish. I do think I'll take a weight, but I'm gonna only take like a 5 weight, I think. No, we are not cutting our tail. We are going to let our Sam blood flourish. We will come back out and we're gonna try and get some of these moves, but we still need to get a lot stronger. And if you guys don't know, the fastest way to train this game is the time chamber. I mean, technically you don't need it, but the weight that it puts on you helps out a lot with your training. You can only be in there for so long, but it basically makes you earn more. You can already see that I'm kind of walking in here sort of slow, but it's not slow enough to notice. But if I was put on this weight, that's all going to change. So right here, I'll go and put on the weight. There's a special key for that in your settings if you want to know how to actually open up this menu. And now I'm so slow. I'm weighted down. I literally can't hardly move. Now, if I was to power up, I can actually move a little quicker, but it's not enough. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to fight some training dummies here because obviously training dummies give you a lot of TP and it's going to help us out with our journey. Now, to get even more, I can power down from 50% to like 5 or 10% because the more hits you have, the better from what I hear. And that's what I've always done. Now, I might not be able to kill him. He's obviously probably going to kill me. He's stronger than me. You can kill the dummy if you just go full power, but I'm just going to go ahead and let him kill me like that. And then I should get a pretty good amount of TP. And I brought some Sensu beans just to help me train, but this obviously isn't going to be enough, so I might have to go get some food. Maybe I'll try and find a Rocky biome. I'm going to have that for the story anyways, but we're going to see. Okay, so we're going to take a small break here. Nothing huge. I'm not done training yet because I need to train a lot more before we're ready. But I'm going to come out here and we're going to try and get some skills and stuff. I have a little over 10,000 TP, which, I mean, it's to be expected. I made my mind increase so much bigger now that it's helping speed things up. This is still like nothing though. I'm going to need a lot more. I can learn a skill now because I have 51 mind from where I put all my stuff into mine. We're going to go ahead and do potential unlock, which allows me to go to 55% now. And we can also do other things. So like endurance, meditation, key sense. I am going to do key sense this time because I learned key sense is pretty fire. I'm not going to lie. You guys were right. It's pretty nice. We're going to go and increase our constitution. We're going to put a lot more into mind. I want to learn fly. Let me learn fly, because if I can fly, that is huge. This is a massive thing for us. As you can see, I can fly around, and it's just really useful to have, because if you don't have fly in this, you're missing out. You've got to have fly, and the earlier, the better to have it, even if it's not super quick. It's just good to have. Now, these other, I'm going to wait on. I don't really need those right now, and I don't really need any key moves right now. I'm trying to focus purely on my strength. I get my first super form at 1,000 TP, which I already have. I just need mind. But you know what? I might wait on that because honestly, I might need just as much mind as possible to grow even faster. So we're going to go ahead and put more into mind. We're going to put 100 into mind. Ooh, it's a lot to put in there. I know it's a lot to put in, but we're going to get the super form next. We're going to come back on the next time when I'm done training like right now, I'm going to come back and we're going to actually do this. We're going to get the super form and we'll probably do some of the story missions. I'm going to go ahead and do my strength a bit. Oh, I don't even think I mentioned it last time, but I did gain a second Dragon Ball. I don't know if I ever mentioned that, so I'm going to say it now. I did get a second Dragon Ball. Pretty good. Now I still have 1,000 TP left over. I'm really thinking of just like doing more strength and then maybe a bit more constitution. Just a little bit more in my stats in general. Now we're at 10,000 battle power. That's what I mean by it's not that much different, especially when I'm putting most of my stats into mind, because it's going to take me a bit just to get the TP gain going, because I need a lot of TP to eventually keep up with this. I'm already having to spend 200 TP just to level up one stat, and it just becomes more and more expensive each time. So that's why I'm putting a lot into my mind, because I grow faster. It's also going to help me get more of these quicker. So I'm going to go for the super form first. And we might upgrade our potential unlock a bit. But yeah, we're finally making some good progress. Oh crap, I better go get a Sensu Bean from Korn's Lookout. I don't think I've gotten my Sensu Bean today, so I'm gonna go down there. I don't think I even explained this earlier either. So basically what I do when I'm training is that every day, every Minecraft day, I come out here, I come down, and I get a Sensu Bean. It's pretty easy. Now it is a little hard to train up there in the Hyperbolic Time Chamber for long without dying. Because, I'll be honest, you're going to... Oh, I should probably go and get a Flying Nimbus. I mean, I don't really need it, but I'll go ahead and get it. I didn't get it last time because I already have a teleport. But, yeah, I can just constantly come down here, get a Sensu Bean, and hop back in. And if I don't have a Sensu Bean, I normally just die, go and reset my HP, and then I'm good to go. You can do the slash kill command, or you can just go die from a mob. It does not matter, either way. And then you just respawn and come back here and keep training. But either way, this is the best way that you can do it. Now, there is a time limit for how long you can be in here, so I have to be mindful of that, but I've extended how long I can be in here in my settings. Either way, let's go ahead and do some more training. Oh, man, I'm already about out of ki. I'm an idiot. Let me power down. I don't need much ki to attack this guy anyways. I'm going to go 25%, and look, I can just walk around. That's pretty funny. Put back on the way, and time to get back to some training. Okay, we're finally ready to do our big power-up. So, now we can finally put in our stats. There's a lot of training in this mod, and it takes days. But I finally got to a point where I'm starting to get a pretty good amount of TP. Now, 10,000 was alright, but 50,000? Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. So we're gonna go and get our super form. Not once, but twice. Meaning we can go to Super Saiyan. Oh, wait. Let me power up. Let's power up a bit. We can go ahead. We're gonna go to 55%. Oh, let me increase my key pool. Because I need to have a lot more key to withstand this form. I'm going to use a lot to go ahead and get us a bigger key pool. So now we went like 5 times more key. Anyways, now we're going to go ahead and transform. And this is what Super Saiyan 1 looks like. Not bad. But I can also go a step further. Ascended Super Saiyan. And obviously, I'm just a little bit bigger. And you can see I'm a lot faster. My power level is now 226,000. It's a huge leap. You can see where it modifies my stats. I'm a lot faster. Now, if you know one thing about Vegeta, he has the Majin symbol in the Majin arc. I can go get that at any time I want, but I have to be evil to be able to unlock it. So we're going to keep that in mind. But we do have to be neutral to get the God form. So we can't have both. Actually, wait, no, you can get the Majin. I think you can actually get the Majin symbol when you're neutral, if I'm not mistaken. If not, it might be the God form that you get. Like, I can go neutral first, get the God form, like right here, the God Destruction form, and then I can go and I can get the Majin symbol, but that's going to be in the future. Right now, we're just rocking with the Ascended Super Saiyan. But let's go ahead and power down so we don't lose all of our key, and let's go ahead and put in more stats. So we're going to go ahead and immediately put in more mind. I know, it's crazy. Why are you putting in more mind? It's because we're going to put some stuff into our skills, and we need mind to activate our skills. So, potential unlock one more time. And then, I could do another super form. Screw it. You know what? We're going to go ahead and unlock grade 3. Now, grade 3 is like a fatter Super Saiyan. And I'll show you guys that later when I actually turn into it. If you haven't seen my other videos. I'm acting like you haven't seen my other videos, but if you have, you already know the drill. And there is going to be new stuff that you haven't seen in the future. Either way, we're going to go ahead and get this up to 50 strength because our melee damage is almost to 100. Let's get that to 100. All right, that's not bad. And that's without a form. Dexterity, we're going to get that up to 30. Constitution, we're just going to put the rest in the Constitution. See if we can get that to 50. All right, we did. And we'll put the rest into Mind. That way I grow even faster. And now we have a whopping power level. of 48,000, but not just them. We can actually go potential unlock to 60%, 52,000 power level in our base. Pretty huge. We have 1,100 HP now. And if I was to transform, you'll see what my true stats look like. So first we have Super Saiyan 1 at 245,000. Ascended Super Saiyan, 475,000. And then finally, Grade 3. The biggest stage. The stage that's supposed to be slower but stronger. If you've seen the actual show, Goku actually says that he's also found out about this form, but he doesn't want to use this form because he realizes it's a good form. It's stronger, but it's going to make you weaker because you're slower. It's stronger, but slower. It's too muscular. It's too beefy. It's kind of funny looking in the actual show. I'll put a picture on the screen. And basically, the only person that actually does this is Trunks, because Trunks thinks he's going to be smart. And he's like, yeah, I've unlocked a bigger power than you, father. Vegeta knew about it, too. He just decided not to use it for the same reason. Goku decided not to use it, but Trunks didn't realize that. Either way, in the actual game, though, at least for me, it's just the same. It's basically just a stronger version, so it's actually better than assumed in Super Saiyan. It's about 600,000 battle power. That's huge. And at our base, we're at 52,000, so just imagine how much of a multiplier that is. It's insane. Forms are huge in this mod. So now we're actually able to do a lot of the story. I did not find a Rocky biome, but I'm going to continue to look. But first, why don't we just go and do some of the stories? So we're going to go down to the island, and we're going to prepare to do the story. Oh yeah, there's still like the mob drops out here. Maybe it just doesn't despawn because I'm in the hyperbolic time chamber for so long. Look at that! You have the key sense, thing. It didn't register my first attack. I was kind of confused, but either way, here we go. There's just a bunch of islands, man. A bunch of islands. Well, this island's about to get destroyed, probably. So let's go ahead and start. You feel an unpleasant energy. Are you prepared for this? Oh, I'm prepared. Talk to Master Roshi. I forget about this every time! But luckily, guess where we are? In the freaking ocean. Meaning that we can easily figure out where Master Roshi's house is. I just have to go fly around and... so that was the minion mod, by the way. I still have that way back from the Black Frieza video. But yeah, we're going to use the Flying Nimbus because it doesn't make us use our key. That's the only reason I'm using the Nimbus right here, because I don't have to over-exhaust myself looking for the Master Roshi home, like Kame house. So now what I'm going to do is Kame's house only spawns in the ocean. So I have to look around in this giant ocean hoping that I find Master Roshi's house. Now, it's not actually just somewhere. It spawns in at random. So if I go into the ocean long enough, eventually Master Roshi's house should spawn and I'll be able to go talk to him. And then we can continue, but it's going to take a bit. Ladies and gentlemen, Kame house. Now you're probably wondering, Timmy, how did you not see this? A lot of you are probably screaming at me right now, like, Timmy, you've had Kame house, the underneath Kame's lookout, this entire video. How did you not notice this? Because I'm stupid, okay? I forgot. I've been in the time chamber so long, I'm like, alright, where's Master Roshi's house? I always mark it. I didn't mark it this time. So what I did was I'm like, okay, I'm not finding this. Where the heck is it, right? So I come back to Kame's lookout, and I go to get a Senzu bean. And as I'm coming to fly down, I'm like, bruh. Because it's literally right here. There's literally just like Master Roshi right here underneath it. It was underneath my feet. Underneath me this entire time. It was right underneath my nose, quite literally. So, yeah. I wasted days of time looking for this guy that I should have already have known where he was. I am actually stupid. I don't have to come back here, at least. He doesn't teach anything really useful. He can teach Kamehameha, but I don't really need that right now. What we will do, though... I hate you, man. This is like the 80th time I've had to search for you. This time it was actually easy to find you, and I still couldn't find you. That's ridiculous, man. How is that even possible? Because I'm stupid. Anyways, so now we have to decide whether we want to be good, evil, or neutral. I think we're going to be neutral. Are we already neutral? No, we're not. We're going to be for myself. I think we have to be completely neutral to be able to get the God of Destruction form. And we're going to go for that early on because I'm hoping to get the God of Destruction form and then get the Majin symbol. I don't need a second Flying Nimbus. What the heck? Now, we have to kill Yamcha. So now we can go over here to the island and let's go ahead and kill Yamcha. And here we go. Bro, Yamcha. 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 How did I not one-shot you? Man, whatever. Myself. My. Shoe. Pilaf. Okay. Bonk. Bonk. I'm not even using a form for you guys right now. Easy. Okay, maybe it's like the Saiyan ego coming out. You know, like I got that pride. Bro, get out of here. Easy. Like, it's not, honestly, some of these guys are just way too easy. Now, I will say, there has been an issue with DBC recently that you guys have addressed and I've addressed. That basically, once you get to the Mecha Frieza Saga, it seems like the game is actually broken. Now, I think there is a way to fix that in the configs, but you have to skip over the arc, and it's like, it's a really complicated process, and I'm not big brain enough to do that. I might try and look into it and make a video on how to do it so you guys can do it, but I'm hoping they'll just fix it. But I don't think they've fixed it yet, have they? I might have to get like a new version to actually fix it. I'm not sure. News 3 weeks ago. Wait. Contained a handful of bugs, so this release should fix them. So I thought. Okay, so it should be fixed now. Let's go. Hopefully it's fixed. So maybe now I can actually go past the Mecha Frieza Saga for once. Let's go. I just fought Yamcha, dude. Gonna fight him again? Dude. Die! Where are you going? Stop running! Jeez. Oh my gosh. These mobs are actually insane. Alright, Jackie Chun. Alright, Jackie Chun. Let's go. And you're dead. Yep. Honestly, it's just too easy at first until you get to the Saiyan Saga. Then it really starts amping up the power. I don't need that. You know what? Just to flex on him. Boom. Boom. Great ape. Alright, so now our power level is a whopping 130,000. Without really taking anything out of me. And I could also go Super Saiyan in this state if I wished, but I will not yet. Not yet. Oh, now we're fighting Colonel Silver. Okay, that's the most iconic Dragon Ball character of all time. You ask, can Colonel Silver beat Goku? No, we cannot. It's one of the most asked questions in all of Dragon Ball. Ninja Murasaki. And now we have a sword, which you know what we'll use just to get some extra damage, but it's kind of useless for us. But yeah, you can kind of speed through the original Dragon Ball Saga. Now, if I had, like, not have had such a high TP gain, it probably would have been more fair, and I probably would have had to have, like, done this story, and it would have actually been a struggle. But for me, it's just, like, easy, because I've already gotten so powerful. These guys feel like nothing. They really feel like nothing. General Blue. Yeah, you've met Colonel Silver. Now get ready for General Blue. Alright, you guys are actually getting kind of annoying, and I didn't want to have to hit you a dozen times. So, let's show them what a golden great ape looks like. That's right. Now, it's still not as strong as my grade 2 or grade 3, but it should do. I'm holding back of them, flexing on them with my monkey form, and they're dead. It's working. Mercenary Tao, dead. End of the RR. Yep, goodbye, Red Ribbon. Whoa, 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 whoa! There's a lot. Okay, get your machine guns and bazookas and Fortnite emotes out of here. Alright. And now I've already got a lot of TP already. We're building that up quick for myself. Since we have no limiters, we're not getting it quite as much as like the actual time chamber. But it's still good. I might have to train again, or at least get some Sensu beans. I gotta find me a rocky biome. I have to. Because that'll get me some dinosaur meat, and that'll be a lot more stable. For myself. Oh, not my enemy! The Invisible Man. Who will win? I mean, right now, I'm kind of big. And I don't know if I'll be able to really hit him. We'll see. He's annoying. Oh, wait, I get key sense. Oh, yeah, that's right. Comment section. I forget about that every time. Key sense helps me see him. If only I'd actually used key sense way back when my house got blew up in that one video, man. That would have been good. I forget you guys always tell me to use key sense to find him. I actually had it this time. That saved my life. I have 6 of the 7 Dragon Balls. We're getting close. But I don't have a Sensu Bean, and it's turning nighttime. Okay, well, we'll continue this another day. They get to live for now. I need to go train, and I need to get some more Sensu Beans. Perhaps I'll even look for a Rocky Biome. I might wait on the Rocky Biome for now, but after this next time of me doing a story, I am definitely going to go find a Rocky Biome to get some food. Because I'm going to have to. It's just going to help out a lot. Alright, so now it's time for another power buff. I've just been using Sensu Beans, and we finally got to a point where we have 237,000 TP. Now, we're still neutral, and I want to see if we can go ahead and get this God of Destruction form, because can we? We have it. Now, only if your heart is ready for it. Accessible and... Okay, so what's like the... Wait, can I actually... Oh, I can go grab destruction mode just like that? Okay, but what... Can I not do it if I, like, go evil or something? Or do I, like... That's the question. Alright, well, we're gonna try and get the Majin symbol, and if nothing else, first we have to find Bobbity's hut. That way we can get the Majin symbol for Vegeta. And let's see if we can combine them. Because we might be able to combine the Majin symbol with the God Destruction form. And if nothing else, we can do the Majin symbol with Ultra Ego, and then we can do God Destruction. There's so many. We can even do God Destruction and Ultra Ego at the same time. It's about to be really crazy. So prepare for that. And we still have 187,000 left over. So yeah, let's go ahead and just start putting this in. So we're going to increase our mind even more because I need more mind. Just a lot of mind. It helps go even faster. We're going to do this to actually make it go up a little quicker. Increase our constitution. Increase our strength. Increase our dexterity. And then increase our potential unlock. That's what I'm talking about. And then we'll put some more into our mind. Unlock another super form. So now we can go Super Saiyan 2. And yeah, we're just getting like ridiculously powerful. I'm not even going to lie. Don't mean to do that. Let's go ahead and increase our spirit so we have a bigger key pool. Look at our power level just going up and up. Now, I'm going to try and charge up as much as my potential unlock lets me. It's at level 4. I should better go further than this, right? 60% all I can do? Huh. Okay. Well, let me change that real quick. Doop, doop. Bonk. Now I can go 65%. No? Why am I not able to go up? Do I have to, like... Oh, okay. That's why. Oh, okay. Jeez. All right, so 75%. I waste the whole Senzu Bean just to show that, but hey. It is what it is. God Destruction's already maxed. Makes me wonder what God Destruction looks like already. This is nowhere near my full power, but can I actually go God Destruction right now? It acts like I'm charging up. But am I? Maybe I'm not strong enough. But only if your heart is ready for it. Well, I'm in complete neutral right now. So why is it not working? That's the question. Off, on, now will it work? I think before we can actually do it, I think we have to have the actual God forms, and I think we need to be a bit further, so we can't use the God Destruction form yet, and that's okay. But what I'm wondering, where's my super forms? Oh, are they just already there? Okay, there's already there. Do we have Super Saiyan 2? why am I so fed? It's so goofy. I have 4.4 million. I thought I unlocked another super form, but I guess not yet. I'm not at that point. Either way, oh, that's right. We unlocked Perfect's form. Basically, like, our Super Saiyan state at first is actually now stronger than it used to be, but it's still better to be in, like, grade 3 or grade 2, so I don't really see the point. What I will say now is that we're ready to go take on some more bosses and stuff. So we're about to go do that. We're going to increase our strength way more. So we do more damage. Just a ton of damage. And more dexterity. And more constitution. I'm just spamming everything. Okay, now we have almost 7 million at our full power. This is currently as strong as we can go. So, let's go back to the island. And let's try and continue this. Because we have a lot to go. We're still very early on. Bandages, die. I'm not taking no time. Spike, die. And you know what? We're going to start going evil so we can actually get the Majin symbol. Because I want to get that before I get the God Destruction form anyways. Because canonically, that makes more sense. He had the Majin symbol before he ever even got Ultra Ego. And he hasn't got God Destruction yet, but there's a lot of fan theories that he can get it. And if he was to get it, it would be near the end of the series, not the start. So it only makes sense that we start off with the Majin symbol first. Well, whether I can actually use the Majin symbol with it, I'm unsure. It might not allow me to use the Majin symbol with the God Destruction form, but we'll see. It'd be kind of cool if you could. We'll only be able to find out through just trying it out and seeing if we can. Tien. Going for Sick of Evil again. After this, we can go look and see if we can find the Majin symbol and maybe even the Rocky Biome. Because we got to find both of those anyways. So we can just go travel around for a bit and see if we can find those. But first, let's just try and get through maybe even the Sand Saga. Actually, to get to the Sand Saga, we need the Rocky Biome. So we'll go ahead and beat the whole Dragon Ball Saga. I keep doing it for myself and messing myself up. There we go. We are going to do the whole Dragon Ball Saga, and then we're going to go and we're going to find the Rocky Biome, which will help us out a lot. We now have 7 Dragon Balls. We can go ahead and summon the dragon if we want. You know what? Screw it, we will. And what we're going to ask for? Yep. Give me 3 Senzu Beans. This will help me with training. Also, maybe like fights if I need it. So I'll take it. We're going to go for Senzu Beans for the sake of evil. Now, there are other wishes, but like, they're really only useful if it's going to take you a while to get stronger. Where in this, I just have it set to where I can get to max in 100 days. So it's like, it's a lot quicker. Realistically, it would probably take you like hundreds of days to get to a good spot in this, unless you have some sort of cheap way of getting TP quickly. But where I've adjusted my TP gain in the settings, it's very possible for me to get maxed out in 100 days. We're going to go ahead and head to the lookout, and we're going to go to Kami. Hey, man. And then now we can continue. Piccolo Jr. time. This is the Piccolo we all know and love. If you haven't seen the original Dragon Ball, it's actually really good. It's really funny. Cyborg Mercenary Tao. And then for sake of evil, Tien Shinhan. I actually read the manga for Dragon Ball and it's really good. Like, I own Dragon Ball, mainly Dragon Ball Z. I don't actually own the Dragon Ball, like original Dragon Ball manga, but I do own Dragon Ball Z. I'm talking about this why I kill everyone in this arc. It's kind of hilarious. And now finally Piccolo at his full power. He's going to be a giant because Namekians can actually do that. It's funny. All right, now for sake of evil. Now, after a long journey, it's over. Now, the Saiyan Saga starts, but I have to find the Rocky Biome. And since it's during nighttime anyways, I think this is a good spot to go ahead and start the search for the Rocky Biome. I'm also going to keep an eye out for Bobbity's hut, because I have to find Bobbity, man. That's going to get me the Majin symbol. Since I'm fully evil, I can finally make good use of it. Let's go ahead and power down so we're not using all of our ki. You can see that our ki is now red, because we're evil. We're going to go ahead and use our Nimbus. Since we're early on in the story, we're evil, but we're not always going to be evil. We'll eventually change that. Because I'm evil now, I can't use this Nimbus. That's right. Well, looks like I gotta get the other Nimbus. I have to go get the dark Nimbus. The Nimbus that works for the evil side. It kind of sucks to have to go probably do this again. I'm probably going to have to go get a golden Nimbus again after I go back to being good. But it is what it is. Get a dark flying Nimbus. Thanks, man. All right, now time to begin the search. I am still just flying around looking for some form of life. Okay, there's been plenty of life, but it's just like mostly just like a snow biome. You can see how far I am away. I'm just literally going straight. A lot of it was ocean. I finally started to see land, but I just saw a spruce biome and then some sort of like snow biome. I'm just currently just going completely straight until eventually I find something. Ooh, wait. It's just an island. Okay, there's more land. I'm just trying to find a rocky biome or some sort of plains biome, hopefully. It's very laggy, so it takes a bit to get across. It's just because it's an old version of Minecraft, but that's the only way to play DBC, from my knowledge. So yeah, I'm just going to keep looking. Eventually I'll find it, but it's taking a very long time, and it's usually like this. So I recommend if you play DBC, try and get a good spawn. Try and find a spawn that's like near a lot of good places. This is not a good spawn. I don't recommend this one, but this is what I have to deal with. Oh, I finally found the Bobbity ship. Where is it? Where is it? Where's the Bobbity ship? It says I found it, but I don't see it. It's got to be somewhere close. It'll spawn in once I get close to it. Aha, there it is. Oh, finally, we found the Bobbity ship. Oh my goodness, this took forever, and I still haven't found the Rocky Biome. This is such a shame. It's got to be close, though. I'm finding a lot more biomes, so I think I'm finally getting to a good spot. Oh! I am so lucky I didn't die there. I didn't have my energy on, so dude, this entire time, I tried to, like, fly, and I was like, wait a second, my energy's not released, and then blunk. Either way, hey, dude, I'm going to need the Majin symbol, and I'm going to set a TP here. We're going to call you Ugly. Yeah, okay, now, now we have the Majin symbol effect, and you can see that it's giving us a buff. It's not a huge buff, but it's a buff, and you can see on our head, we officially have the Majin symbol. We're getting somewhere. Now, if we get Super Saiyan 2, it'll really have the full effect, and then we can eventually get God of Destruction, Ultra Ego, all of that. But one step at a time. This is taking a bit. Vegeta didn't get all of his power all at once. It took time to build that. Lots of training. Just like it's gonna take me lots of time to find this Rocky biome that I need to find for the Saiyan Saga. Okay, we finally found the Rocky biome. Woohoo! I found it. Let's go. Man, this took forever. We found Bobbity's ship and we found the Rocky biome just by going a straight shot. So that worked out just perfectly. We're going to go ahead and set a TP up here so we don't lose this again. There's no dinosaurs that spawned yet, but I literally just got here. They'll start spawning in pretty quickly. And that'll be a new source for food for me. Sadly, though, it's kind of useless now because I'm about to be at the Frieza Saga where I get medical liquid from being at the, Namek. Like, there's just a bunch of medical liquid that you can find, like, that you can craft through medical moss, which I'll talk about that when we actually get there. Either way, now, let's see what our power level actually is after I set a TP. We're going to call that Rocky. I know there's a capital O, but we're just going to ignore that. My finger slipped on the ship key. All right. And now we're going to go. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. We're officially over 1,000,000 battle power in our base, which scares me because it means in our actual form, how strong are we going to be? Ooh. Ooh, grade 3 is as high as we can go now, and it's almost 10 million. That's ridiculous. Okay. Goodbye, Cybermen. Goodbye. Nope, time to die. Goodbye. You know what? I'll use the power pole just to do an inch more damage. Easy. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Now, for myself, maybe if... Oh, I don't have to be completely evil to have the Majin symbol. Let's go! So I can go back to neutral, and I can probably have the Majin symbol and the God of Destruction form, which will be pretty sick. Maybe we can't unlock it yet because we're not strong enough, but eventually. Now we'll do for myself again. I gotta get dinosaur meat. Are you serious? I freaking felt that. Well, let's kill the Cybermen first. Get out of here. Get absolutely destroyed. Nah, man. I'll take on a whole army of you guys. Just don't get glitched, please. That's all I ask. Looks like I don't have enough constitution. I don't have enough body time. This is where key moves would come in handy. My yellow bar on the right is completely gone. It's filling back up slowly, but it's not enough. When I have to attack this much, it requires a lot of constitution. Not just for HP, but for action time. I guess it's time to go killing dinosaurs. All right, we're officially ready. I just put a lot of stats into my constitution. Well, all my TP that I code into my constitution. And a little bit in the strength, but mostly in the constitution. And I cooked up some dinosaur meat, and we're officially ready to go. And we're going to go ahead and do for myself again. So now we have to kill Vegeta and Nappa. And we're going to go ahead and form up for it. I turned off my form just so it wouldn't exert a bunch of ki. And here we go. Ready again. We're officially over the 10 million point. Let's go. Now, let's kill Nappa first. No chance. Get out of here. All right, Vegeta, you want some? I'll show you who the real prince of all Saiyans is. That was a little anticlimactic. Either way, the clone version of me is not that good. He's kind of trash. I'm not going to lie. So now we can actually go to the other planet. So we're going to immediately get our butts over to Namek. We're not going to Planet Vegeta. It's literally just an apocalypse of endless sands. There's no point of being there, and it's terrifying. Other than just killing a bunch of sands, it's kind of useless. Now, when I said medical moss, that's my first objective here, because I'm not strong enough to kill Frieza yet, not even close. But there is medical moss that I can find in Namek. There's some. There's some right there. We need to find this to help us actually get stronger. It helps heal us so we can actually heal up our HP while we're trying to train. So we never have to use our sensor beams in that. Right here, we get some medical moss. I'm going to collect up some of this and we're going to make some medical liquid. That way I can actually do some more training. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some medical liquid and then I'm going to go train. I'm going to get back to you guys once I've done that. And you guys will see my little setup of where I'm training. My power knows no limits. After this, at least. I have made the ultimate setup, I believe. So, like, I come in here, right? I sit, and I can just straight up punch away at the Shadow Dummy without them being able to hurt me. And this medical liquid constantly heals me, and since my HP isn't even that big, it's pretty easy I'm not gonna lie, so like I have a perfect little setup to heal myself and constantly train nonstop. I've already got 1.5 million TP. That's right, 1.5 million. We're about to jump up big time. So first off, we're gonna go ahead and lock our next form, Super Saiyan 2. And we're not gonna waste no time. We might even go ahead and skip that and go to the next form. What? You're already going to the next form? Yep, that's right, I'm going higher. We're gonna max it out, Super Saiyan 3 and Super Saiyan 4. But since Vegeta doesn't have Super Saiyan 3, we're not using Super Saiyan 3. Super Saiyan 4, however, we can use, because technically that does exist. So we now have Super Saiyan 2 and Super Saiyan 4. We're gonna stick to Super Saiyan 2 right now. I just wanna see what we look like and how much battle power we have. Oh, that's right, that's just normal Super Saiyan. This is Super Saiyan 2. Yeah! About 15 million. We got the sparks flying everywhere and the Majin symbol. It's pretty good. We're having a huge amount of power. And we're still alignment with evil. We're going to change that to neutral real quick, and we'll be good to go. Now, on top of that, I can also go up to Super Saiyan 4 now, but I have to do that at nighttime and in Grade 8 mode. We might go ahead and do that later, so that'll be cool. Let's get out of our form now, just so we don't waste all of our key. Turn off turbo mode. And now we still have 939,000 left over. I am going to go ahead and max out my potential unlock just to go ahead and get that out of the way. These are huge milestones to help us really reach our full potential, so I don't see them as waste. Plus, I'm getting more mind, which means I train faster. It's gonna help. We now have full potential unlock, meaning we can go to 100% of our power. We finally can tap into 100% of everything we train. Our whole body is huge. Now, I still have 864 left over, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and put these into our actual stats. That's what we're gonna do with these left over. I mean, I could put some into these, but it's not really that worth it. Key Sense is just like a nice little add-on. It's nothing like huge for me right now. Now what I can do is go ahead and put more into my actual key. We're gonna need that. Constitution, gonna need that. And now we're just about out, but that's okay. We'll put the rest in the strength. And I would put more into dexterity, but I think I am basically broke. I probably put way too much into my spirit, to be completely honest. Oh my god. Yeah, look at my top left. It's almost 20 million in my base now. And let's go and eat. Yep. Uh-huh. So now we're getting somewhere big. Now, the bad part is we're not strong enough to actually go ahead and get our God forms yet, because we just wasted all of our TP. But that's okay. We have plenty of time, and what we have now is going to be enough to go ahead and get us through the next parts of the story. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wait till daytime, and then we can go, and we'll head over there, and we'll actually do some of the story quests. I just don't feel like doing it at nighttime. I don't like nighttime. So in the meantime, I'm gonna train just a little bit more. Okay, so here we go. I've officially got like 300,000 more, and I'm gonna see if I can go and get the God form just to get it out of the way. Oh, he doesn't want to talk to me right now. Hey, buddy. Buddy, friend. No, okay, fine. All right. Well, can I use God Destruction by any chance? That's the question. I don't think I can do it because I'm evil. I think I gotta be neutral. So I need to start working towards being neutral, and then we probably can. I think we also have to have the God forms unlocked, which, like I said, I can't do unless I'm neutral at the least. So we're going to try and go complete neutral and see if that'll help. So let's go ahead and head over to... Where do we need to be? Oh, we got to go to Namek. That's right. I forgot. We're at the Frieza Saga. Well, he's about to get destroyed. And I'm not even going to waste my time with him. I'm going to get him just absolutely destroyed this time. We got too much to fight this time to let him go all the way up with his forms. It's his fault if he doesn't want to go max power. I'm about to just completely obliterate him. There's not going to be any sort of mercy shown here. Matter of fact, I won't even use a form. I'll just go in my base. So let's go ahead and do this. And then we're going to do for myself. And look, it's going... Wait! The Majin form stops me from going to neutral. Oh, crap! Okay. I think I know how I can get the God form. I might be able to go to, like, maybe King Kai or one of the NPCs to learn God form. And then we'll see if we can do it. But I don't know if I can do it unless I'm neutral. So I might have to give up the Majin symbol soon enough. We'll see. But I'm going to try and make it work. One way or another. But what we will do is we're going to go ahead and beat this. But just our base form. You're all nothing. You stand no chance against me and my Saiyan pride. I'm not even using my form. I'm like Buu Saga at least. And you guys are like Namek Saga, so you're pretty far back. I'm not going to lie. Like, I'm way past even the Cell Saga. This is useless. I mean, like, I don't even know why I put neutral, because it's just going to go straight back. That's funny. I thought it was a little weird that it wasn't neutral yet. So maybe you guys have a little bit more power than I was assuming. Oh, I still have 300,000 left over anyways. I'll save it. No reason to use it now. I'll use it on the God forms. They're pretty expensive. I'll do it after I'm done with this. Tutoria. Okay. I might have to use a form on these guys. They're a little stronger than I thought. So you know what? Boom. Super Saiyan 1. But that's as far as I'm going. That's as much as I'm going to give them a taste of. The legendary Super Saiyan. Ha ha ha. Yes. Let's see. See, the legendary Super Saiyan. The form that Frieza was terrified of and destroyed planet Vegeta for. Yes, that's exactly what I'm going to use. Now we have to fight the Ginyu Force. Yep. Get destroyed. Bodied. Nope. I'm dodging and weaving. Man, there's a lot of you guys. Okay. I'm the second strongest below Master Frieza. This cannot be. Yeah, well, guess what's about to happen to Master Frieza? Well, first I'm going to take his Dragon Ball. No, seriously. Get destroyed. I'm not waiting for you to transform. Transform now or die. That's what I thought. Why, you, if only I transformed, this would have never happened. Yeah, that's what you said the last, like, five episodes that I've made a DBC video. It always happens. Screw you. And you're going to come back as a mecha version of yourself. And I'm not here for all that. For myself. Hey, get... I told you I was going to steal his Dragon Ball, man. I didn't even know he had one. I'm not even going to lie. Oh, I need two more. All right, I'm going to go fly around and look for a Namekian Dragon Ball. Two of them. And then I'll be back once I have those. Because I want to go ahead and summon those and get a bunch of Senshu Beans. And yeah, that's basically it. It's going to take me just a little bit to find them, but it shouldn't take too long. And that's going to help us out with a lot of the story that we're about to have to do. I have assembled all seven of the Namekian Dragon Balls. Now let's summon the Go himself, Purunga. Oh, you're bigger. But you have a very derpy face. Okay, from down here it looks derpy. From up there it actually looks kind of good. Once you get up close. So basically I get three wishes, so I can do multiple things. I'm going to do three Senshu Beans. Three Senshu Beans. Guess what the next one's going to be? Three Senshu Beans. Let's go. That's what I'm talking about. So now we have a ridiculous amount of Senshu Beans. We're good. So now we can go back to Earth in peace. So, let's go ahead and get back to where we belong. I was missing Earth, honestly. I don't like Namekia. I said Namekia? I was about to say Namekia, and then I was like, Namek, and then I was like, I guess in between I said Namekia? Yeah, man, that's the new land that they never told you about, Namekia. New Namek. I wouldn't be surprised if there's something called Namekia out there. There probably is. Either way, let's see what's next in the story. So, I'm gonna do it for myself, even though it doesn't matter. Go to Biome Plains. This is where the Mecha Frieza quest is, and it starts to get very confusing. I can possibly do this, so we're going to go try, but I don't know how it's going to go. We're going to go to Ugly, because he's always in a Plains biome anyways. Poppity, Ugly. Oh my gosh, I don't even know. So, let's go ahead and get out here. Now, we're going to go over here. Inside this plains, because obviously it's the plains area. We gotta go enough far away we're not like in the Bobby ship area, and then we can summon Frieza. Now we have to kill Frieza soldiers first. Draw down here. They are small fry compared to me. I'm not even at my full power. I'm just in Super Saiyan 1. It might be time I go up a bit. So let's go to Super Saiyan 2. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Now you can see the lightning. Super Saiyan 2 Majin. We're pure evil right now. We're at our peak strength without going into Super Saiyan 4. So, for myself again. Now let's kill Mecha Frieza and King Cold. This should work. Yep, okay. Uh-huh. And then the dad just watches. A lot like the Nappa and Vegeta fight. And now he comes in. He's like, oh, you killed my son. It must be the sword. Nope. Dead. Senshu Bean. And now we're going to do... No! What the... It did it again. It did it again. Okay, well, let's go back in and see if it fixes. Okay, I just tried again and it did not work. So it's still bugged. I don't know why, but the story is still bugged. But that's okay, because what this means is we get to entirely focus on getting our forms and the fun stuff. Because I'm really excited to see what Ultra Ego looks like with the Modisim, which I've already done that before. But there's other ideas, such as God of Destruction with Ultra Ego, with the Majin symbol. Imagine if we could stack all three. It's definitely possible. So let's try it. Now, before we can actually do this, before we can actually manage to get our final forms, we have to train more and we have to get every form. We still gotta get the God forms, and I still have to see if I can actually go God Destruction while in my evil form. I don't know if it's possible, but we're gonna try. But first, I gotta get the normal God form. So we're gonna go do that. And then after that, I have all the forms other than what's in the JDE menu. But I'm afraid if I open it, it's going to immediately start playing a Rickroll theme. So I'm going to turn my music down and then I'm going to do that off camera. But basically, there's a second menu where I can get other forms that aren't from the DBC mod. It is something known as the JD or J1's DBC Essentials mod. Basically, it adds in new forms and new races and stuff into the game that aren't in the original Dragon Block Z. So, such as Ultra Ego. So we're going to try adding Ultra Ego in this. That way we can have Ultra Ego. But first we got to get our God forms. And currently I have to go find a way to get the God forms. And to get a little bit stronger. Because right now our power level isn't even able to handle this. So I'm going to go ahead and depower. We do have to take on the side mission though. The Dragon Ball Super Broly movie saga. And we're not nearly strong enough. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the lookout. And I'm going to begin training. For one of the final times. We shouldn't have to train a whole lot, but this is going to be like one of the final times I have to train. And when I come back out, we should be able to get the God forms. Heck, I might even have them, and then we'll be good to go. Okay, guys, so I just unlocked Ultra Ego and the God form. I haven't leveled up the God form, but if I was to go here, you can see I have Ultra Ego, and I can select it, so I can transform my Ultra Ego at any time. So that's now unlocked. But before we do that, I want to go ahead and level up our God form. See, I've got almost 10 million TP. I bought a couple forms. That's why it's a little bit below. I had 10 million, but I had to put into some other stuff first. Let's go ahead and put some into our mind. Level up that God form. Max it off. So now I want to see if we can go into our God of Destruction form. Can we? It's working. Wait. We can be a God of Destruction with the Majin symbol? Oh, that's crazy. Oh no, we're about to be so OP. Because not only can we do it like this, right? So we have God Destruction with our Majin symbol. But now I can also start transforming. And I think it's this. Okay, which button is it? There's a button where I can transform into Ultra Ego. And I'm about to do it. Ascended from Ultra Ego. Oh, look at the aura. Now, we are not just an Ultra Ego user. We're not just a God of Destruction. We have the power of Ultra Ego, the Majin symbol, and the God of Destruction form. This is quite honestly the only thing that could probably rival even that of the Omni King himself. Even Omni King Goku would probably struggle against a power this great. This is insane. I cannot believe this. This is crazy. You can see our face is a little bit more red tinted, and it's because that we've actually got a little bit more strength. Now, what I can do is I can go in and change this to where I have the texture pack for, like, you can see I have, like, a bunch of different texture packs here. X-Ray, this is from, like, 6 years ago, by the way. I don't actually use this. It doesn't even work in, like, the modern day Minecraft. But it's just a fun fact. I used to have that for one of my servers to see if people were cheating. Now, I have... The Super Saiyan 3 face. So I'm going to use the Super Saiyan 3 add-on face. And what this is going to do is it's going to give us like that Ultra Ego kind of look. So now if I was to charge up. Now. We really look like we are just insane. We have the power of a god. But not only that, the power of Ultra Ego. This is ridiculous. Like actually ridiculous. We're not even close to being maxed out in our stats either. I can't believe this. Let's go ahead and max out our ki pool a bit. Constitution. Yeah, a lot of constitution. And strength. And now, there's a Sensu Bean. And let's go see just how much we can do to the Broly Saga before we have to train. Kill Vegeta. Is that all you got? Is that all you got? Bring it on! I'm just too strong. I'm far too strong.
Let's see if you can handle me at my full power.
Oh no, I used the wrong button! Aw, crap. Oh well. You know what? Since we're already just about strong enough, I'm gonna go train a bit more, and I'm gonna max out all of my stats. We're about to skip a lot of days, but since the story is currently broke, and we've almost got everything unlocked, we might as well. I'm gonna go max out everything, and we're gonna unlock a couple new goodies, and then we're gonna finish off this 100 days, because I have an ultimate plan to destroy all this. We're just gonna get as strong as we possibly can, we'll max out every stat, and then we're gonna see if we can take out the entire Broly Saga, and I wanna see, like, what these other skills do, because we've never used them before. It's gonna be really fun. I'll see you guys there. This is what my true power looks like. It's pretty insane. We have Ultra Ego stacked with Majin, stacked with the new God of Destruction form. And on top of that, as you see on the right side, our HP is limitless, practically. And on top of that, we have some new goodies to try out. First off, wait for it. Where is it? I was going to try and add in a bunch of other little goodies, like I said, but I actually got to looking, and it seems like most of them aren't compatible with just how many forms I'm using. So quite literally, we've broken the game to where we just can't get any stronger. Like, this is ridiculous. And let me go turn off this aura for a second so I can actually hear myself speak. This might be my last Dragon Block Z video for a while, because I do feel like these are starting to get kind of repetitive. You might feel the same way, and I am going to do more. But I'm going to change things up in a big way. That way, it really stands out, because I feel like this is good and all, but I've done quite a bit of Dragon Block Z recently. And also, the Dragon Block Z videos have all pretty much led to the same conclusion. And I feel like I'm getting so strong, there's not much of a challenge. I just feel like I'm doing the same thing a lot. I've already did a Vegeta video very similar to this, but this actually has the God of Destruction form instead. I might do the Majin Buu video, and then that'll probably be it for Dragon Block Z. For a bit, until I can figure out something new to do with it. However, it doesn't mean I won't do other videos other than 100 days. I just might not be doing a lot of 100 days content with Dragon Block Z for a while. I might do one more, like Majin, and then I'm going to probably call it quits on the 100 days Dragon Block Z stuff for a while, because I've done so many. Now, 200 days is a possibility, but I want to add in some other bosses or some other sort of Dragon Ball mod to make things better. But so far, this is best I can do. So be expecting a lot of other types of content. I hope to see you guys there as well, because I know a lot of you only watch me for Dragon Ball, and if you do, I mean, I really appreciate it. But a lot of good stuff's coming out soon, and if there's a certain type of video you want to see, let me know in the comment section down below. Now, with that being said, let's go ahead and destroy the Broly Saga. Like I see, all my stats are maxed. Everything is completely maxed. You know what? Might as well go ahead and max this out as well. We are ready. We're not even going to bother with that. And now, let's do, for myself, kill Goku. Boom. Instantly dead. This is sad. I gotta admit, one of the coolest things I ever did was when I had to fight as Omni King Goku, and I didn't even have to touch them and they died. That was so cool, because Ultra Instinct is just built different like that. But you know what? It's okay. Now we have to kill Buff Broly. He's dead too. Myself. Yep, he's dead too. Okay. Yep, he's dead too. And guess what? Guess what? We're done. That's it. Oh, it just restarts. But dude, I literally just... that was actually way too easy. That was kind of anticlimactic. There's nothing on this planet that can stop me. I am quite literally the strongest being in this game right now. Nothing can stop me. Not a single entity in this game has a single chance. Except for... the Shadow Dummy. My greatest enemy that I never fight on the last day. Nope. No, he's dead. He's very much dead. he is very, very much dead. But this is what it would look like if Vegeta got the Majin symbol, became Ultra Ego, and had God of Destruction on top of that, unleashing this insane purple force of fury. Like, it's just insane. I've never seen anything like this in Dragon Ball. And maybe this is something we'll see in the future. Now, he might not use Ultra Ego with the Majin symbol with God Destruction, but he might use Ultra Ego and God Destruction form. Or heck, the God Destruction form alone just pretty much makes him look Ultra Ego anyways, so I don't think there's much of a difference. Really, the only difference here is I have the Majin symbol stacked on top of it, so we look completely evil. I really love this, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video too. So if you did, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and be excited for more videos. This video may not have has been like as impactful as the other 100 day Dragon Block Z videos, but it's because I am starting to get drained in Dragon Block Z. I think I've just about had my fair share of Dragon Block Z content, at least 100 days content. As the sun is setting, so is my 100 day Dragon Block Z content. I might do one more in a couple weeks of Majin Buu, but this might be one of my last ones for a while. Now, don't unsubscribe, don't go anywhere, because I have a lot more Dragon Block Z content coming out that's not 100 days. Just like my Gohan Beast vs. Broly video, which I highly recommend you go check out. But I will be doing other 100-day videos on other types of animes and games. I'm going to have people making mods for me, hopefully, to try and get some really cool original videos that you can't get anywhere else. I also want to increase my editing. I might even pay for an editor. Why am I spilling all this right here? Because most of my fans are going to watch my Dragon Block Z video. You watched it all the way through, didn't you? Do hashtag Fusion if you've watched it all the way through to this point. It shows that you're a real one. You probably did, right? So here, listen up, man. Listen up. I'm talking to you. Yeah, you. No, like dead serious. I'm talking to you right now watching this video. Thank you for watching all the way, and thank you for watching all my Dragon Ball videos. If you're new to the channel, thank you, but I feel like a lot of you are probably just returning, and that means a lot to me, because a lot of you guys think my videos are really funny, and you just genuinely enjoy seeing me play Dragon Ball and Minecraft. I really appreciate it, and if you haven't seen my other videos, you really should, but I feel like a lot of you guys probably have. You've probably checked out at least a couple others, maybe Pixelmon, maybe it was Demon Slayer. Who knows, maybe it was the Gojo video I did a while back in Jujutsu Kaisen. They all have different experiences. Now, I'm going to be doing more, and I want to hear your thoughts. Do hashtag Fusion and say what you want to see me do in the comment section. Even if it's Chainsaw Man, let me know, like, what's a character you'd like to see. Stuff like that. Let me know in the comment section below what you want to see. I love you guys, and I'm very thankful for that you're, like, watching my videos all the way through. If there's a Dragon Block Z video idea you have, let me know. I won't be doing many more 100-day videos in Dragon Block Z. I'm going to do them, but they'll be spread out because I don't want to do too many. I feel like I've done way too many recently, and I think it's time to do something else. Give it a little bit of a break for me and for you guys. So, once again, thank you guys for watching. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and I'm going to see you guys in the next video. This has been Fusion Timmy as Ultra Ego, God of Destruction, Prince Vegeta. And I'm going to see you guys in the next one. Fusion Timmy, signing out.